research involves putting protein complexes into the gas phase of a mass spectrometer and trying to learn as much as we can about them in a new environment. Once you can look at them like that, you can learn things that are actually quite difficult sometimes to capture in other phases. For example, there are membrane proteins which talk to soluble proteins, so they're embedded in the cell wall of the membrane, but they have other parts that they're talking to. And if you try and trap those, it's actually quite difficult for them to communicate between the two halves, because one half is in solution and the other half is in a micelle, for example, or embedded in the membrane. And getting the right phase whereby they can both communicate can be quite challenging. But we found that if we could get them into the gas phase, then we could look at allostery and communication between the head and the base in a very new way. I'm a physical scientist, really trying to apply the expertise that I have to solve biological problems. And very recently, for example, we've been studying the HSP90 series of interactions, and for that we were monitoring about 15 complexes simultaneously. We had to apply all the rigour of a physical chemistry approach to get the rate constants and the equations to match and balance for this very complicated system, and this really told us and informed us about the complexes that could form within the cell. So I think that was, for me, a very nice example of some very sort of rudimentary rate equations and physical chemistry coming in to solve a very complicated biological problem. I'm very proud of that one. When I was quite young, I didn't go to university, and I regret that enormously. I would have loved to have gone now. At the time I thought, oh, you know, it's not for me, I'll go to work and I'll work in industry. But actually, I think I really did miss out on some great times that everybody told me about, which I didn't actually experience. So looking back, I think I made it harder for myself, because I did 7 years of part-time study to get to the point where I could go and do a PhD, whereas if I'd gone the normal route, maybe it would have been a lot different. I think the key to any successful career in science is to follow your passion. And I really believe if you find something that you love, which I was very fortunate to do quite early on, I became very excited about my flying molecules, and I thought, you know, this is what gets me out of bed in the morning, this is why I rush into the lab, and this is why I don't find it hard to, you know, put my whole effort into this. Now my children have all obviously left home, I can completely concentrate and focus on this piece of research. And I think when I started, there were a lot of skeptics, and a lot of people said to me, you know, it will never work, and proteins will turn inside out in the gas phase, it's not really useful. And I thought, but you know, I really believe it. I really think there's something there, and these molecules are trying to tell us something. You know, we just don't understand it at the moment, but once we understand it, it'll be hugely exciting. But I think you have to have passion and conviction for what you're doing. If you lose those, then you really are behind and lost. And I think that's the same whether you're male or female, had a career break or not. You really just have to have that passion and conviction, I think. Thank you.